A very good morning to you all children. Children, I welcome you all to this session of English. And today we will be continuing with our chapter language, singular and plural noun, in which we have seen that up till now Aladdin's wish, and then we saw if the item is one, it is called singular noun, and if it is more than one, it is called plural noun. And for plural, we can add S, as well as in some cases, we can add ES also. So it's time now, and we did these exercises, and it's time to move ahead. Now in this exercise, you have to look at the picture and you have to count the nouns, right? You have to count the nouns in this picture, right? Now see, beneath it is written, first is squirrel. So how many squirrels are there, children? Let us see. This is the one first squirrel. No, this one is not. So there's one squirrel, I think. Yeah, only one. Right? So it will come in singular. Then rocks. Right? Let us see. Other things. How many dogs are there? There we can see only one dog is there. Right? So it will come in singular. So we will write here dog. O-G. Right? Okay. Now, bird, there is more than one bird. So we will write here birds. Right? This is how you have to do it. There are fruits and balls and flowers and everything is there. A boy, a girl. So you will have to divide them into two groups and do this. Right, children? So we move ahead. Now find a difference in these pictures and discuss it with your friends. Now there are two pictures here. See children, there are two pictures here and you have to find out the difference. See, in the first one there is one buffalo. Here, see, this is one buffalo, and here there are more than one. Right? So one difference. Then second one, there is only one sheep and there are many sheeps, right? Regarding hen and cock, you can see they are same. Horse, see here there are two horses and here there is only one. So this is how you will have to find out the difference, right? And you will have to copy them down. That in first picture you will write how many singular things items are there and how many plural. And then in the second picture, you will write down how many singular things are there and how many plural. And then you can compare. Now, learning with the ladybird. So let us see what the ladybird says. To answer questions with any, we can use some, any, or a lot. Are there any dogs? Yes, there are some dogs. Is there any food? Yes, there is a lot of food. Right? We use some and a lot in positive sense when we don't say a number. Right? If we cannot tell the number, we will say some and a lot of. There are some sheep. There is some water. There is a lot of sheep here. There is a lot of water. We use any in question and in negative sentence. Is there any chocolate? No, there isn't any chocolate. Some, any, and a lot are determiners. And A and N are determiners too. Nouns go after determiners. Right, children? Not so determiners kya ho gaya, children? They are A and N. Because they are used for one. They are used for one item. Right? Now, see, we come to determiners. Some, any, a lot. Look at and write some, any, or a lot. Now in the first picture, you can see some sheep, or you can say a lot of sheep, right? Because their quantity is huge. Then some children, some girls, some sheep, some cows, a lot of children, right? So you have to Now you have to, you can see here. Now see the questions. Are there any babies? If there is question, you will write any everywhere. See, are there any? Here also any. Now see the answer. There are cows. One cow. You can see here, children. There's 1, 2, 3. No, not this one. 4. I think 3, 4 cows are there. So you will write. There are some cows. S O M E. Right. Now they are asking about fish. Let us see how many fish are there. There is only 2 fishes. So you will write. There are 2 fish. Now for sheep. 1, 2, 3, 4 here, and then so you will write there is a lot of sheep. There are a lot of sheep, and you will then join them with the answers. Right, children? This is how you have to do this. So we have seen in this chapter about nouns and about singular and plural nouns, and we saw S and ES is added, and then what are determiners? A, any, right? And how they are used. So I hope you liked it as much as I did in making it. Until we meet again, it's a goodbye.